Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new to my channel, my name is Lynn. I'm a medical scientist. I do research on aging and cardiovascular diseases. In today's video, I will talk about something that has been requested by many of you. That is how to become a medical practitioner in China. To come in clear, I got both my master's and PhD degree in cardiology from China. That gave me the opportunity to have a closer look into the process that medical graduates go through to become a medical practitioner. The information in this video is most relevant for those aiming to work as a physician in mainland China. It is also applicable for Hong Kong, Taiwan, and Macau to some extent. For more detailed information, I will leave the links in my description. There are five steps. The first one is you need to qualify for medical licensing exam. If you qualify, then you can apply for visa. Then you apply for medical licensing examination. And if you pass that exam, you register your medical license. And the final step is to apply for job. The Chinese medical licensing process is run by the Ministry of Health. All medical graduates are required to pass the National Medical Licensing Examination. To work as a medical professional, the first step is to be eligible to take the medical licensing exam. There are three categories for Chinese doctor qualification. One is general practitioner, the other one is Chinese traditional medicine, and dentistry or stomatology. For this, you must have a full-time medical degree from Chinese Medical University or international university that is recognized by WHO. You can check the information about international medical university and whether these universities are recognized by WHO or not through World Directory Medical School Search webpage. I put the link for this webpage in my description. The second requirement to be qualified for the license exam is you must have 1 year medical training, in other words, internship, in Chinese Medical University. To do this, international medical graduates have a few options. The first one is you do your bachelor degree medical program in Chinese University, which will take 5 to 6 years, and the final year will have 1 year internship training. The second option is you get your medical degree in international university and then you apply yourself in 1 year internship program in Chinese Medical University. The third option is you enroll yourself in postgraduate medical degree program, which usually have 2 to 3 year medical rotation. There are many master's and PhD medical degree programs available for international medical students with full scholarship. And lastly, one of the most important things to consider is the language. The Chinese medical license exam is written in Mandarin Chinese, so to do the exam, you must know Chinese. Today, there are no English version of this exam, but for Hong Kong, there is an English version, but the Hong Kong license cannot be worked in mainland China and vice versa. So if you meet these three criteria, then you are now eligible to take the exam. Let's talk about the exam itself. The exams have two parts, part one, clinical knowledge, and part two, clinical examination. Let's talk about the written exam. It includes four sections, preclinical medicine, clinical medicine, medical humanity, and preventive medicine. In preclinical medicine, they will test you the knowledge on anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, pathology, pharmacology, microbiology, and immunology. Clinical medicine will be about cardiovascular diseases, respiratory diseases, digestive system related diseases, diseases about urinary and reproductive system, neuropsychiatric system, nervous system, pediatric diseases, infectious diseases, sexually transmitted diseases, hematology and rheumatology related diseases, and all these sorts of diseases. Medical humanity is about medical psychology, medical ethics, and sanitary regulations. Preventive medicine covers medical statistic, epidemiology, preventive medicine, public health, and health management. Let's move to part 2, clinical exams. This will cover the bedside manner, history taking, and physical examination, and case analysis. Let's move to visa application. You can apply for a visa or student visa at Chinese Embassy and Consulate with the internship acceptance document or degree program accepted documents, depending on the type of your enrollment for the internship training. Let's move to medical licensing examination application. You can apply for the exam at the local medical licensing examination office if you meet those three major criteria that I mentioned above. They will review your application, and once it is approved, you will receive an examination admission ticket. You can apply for the exam either online or on-site. Online registration usually happens in February to March of every year. On-site registration is a little later, which is March to April of every year. The clinical skill exam will start earlier. If you don't pass the clinical skill, then you will not be able to sit for the written exam. Clinical skill exam is usually in June to July, and the written exam is usually in September to October. Now let's move to medical license registration process. If you pass both clinical and written exam, you will be awarded the doctor qualification certificate, which will be printed exclusively by Ministry of Health and will be issued by Provincial Health Administrative Department. Then you will need to register your medical license at the local health management department. Your license certificate is valid for 2 years. If you fail to practice within 2 years, then you will need to resit for the exam and you will need to go through this whole process all over again. Now let's move to job application. Once you get the license, yes! Congratulations! You can now work as a physician in China. You can search for job in International Chinese Hospital. The hospitals in Beijing, Guangzhou, and Shanghai have a high demand for the foreign medical doctors. I hope this information is useful for you. If you have any additional questions, feel free to comment down below. I will get back to you ASAP. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so. If you find this information useful, please give me a big thumbs up. If you wanted to know the pros and cons of working as an early medical scientist in China, you can click on this video. If you wanted to know the life of a postdoc in USA, you can click on this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a great day. Bye-bye.